A chain reaction is about to happen above the North Pole that's going to wreak havoc on weather patterns worldwide. This is going to increase the risk for intense storms and cold air blasts across the US, meaning that many areas that have been spared from winter weather so far this year are likely in for a rude awakening from Old Man Winter. In many regions of the eastern US and Europe, winter has been relatively mild, resulting in empty ski resorts and early signs of spring such as pollen and budding flowers. But that's all about to come to an end, as the weather patterns that have been causing this warmth are about to get shot down like a Chinese spy balloon. To figure out what's about to happen here, we have to start by looking at the atmosphere above our atmosphere, which is known as the stratosphere. Much of our weather happens in this first layer of the atmosphere called the troposphere, but there's all kinds of different weather systems happening above that in the stratosphere. One of the most notable weather phenomena that occurs up there is this huge swirling cyclone of Arctic air that locks in cold air around the North Pole. This is called the stratospheric polar vortex, and the edges of this vortex are basically what we usually call the polar jet stream. Right now, the jet stream is so out of whack, giant waves are forming on the edges of the polar vortex. This is actually going to cause the vortex to crash into itself, and the winds are going to weaken and then start going in reverse. This is going to release all that cold air that it had locked up. And as it goes down towards the troposphere, it's going to heat up as much as 120 degrees as it falls. This is what meteorologists call a sudden stratospheric warming event. And basically, in a nutshell, this means that there's going to be a bunch of disturbances to our weather patterns as we go forward. Large waves in the jet stream and Arctic air spillage will lead to bigger storms happening on a more regular basis. We know all of this because sudden stratospheric warming events happen every other winter or so, but the intensity of their effect on the polar vortex and resulting weather patterns vary. In fact, some stratospheric warming events, or SSWs, are classified as minor, especially when there's only small changes that occur with the winds inside of a polar vortex. However, the SSW we're about to see is forecast to be major, which is when it's so disrupting that the polar vortex winds actually reverse. The most notable SSW in recent memory happened in 2018. Just like this year, 2018 was pretty mild through mid-February. But then the stratosphere suddenly warmed and weather mayhem unfolded over a lot of Europe and the eastern side of North America. In late February, a blast of Siberian air, later called the Beast from the East, invaded Europe, leading to the coldest weather they had seen in years. And then in March, frigid air came into eastern North America and set the stage for four huge snowstorms in the Northeast. This is what could actually happen this year thanks to the polar vortex falling apart. Now, I put together some forecast maps based off of this SSW that entail how I think the weather patterns are going to change for us. And if you're one of these people who are hungry for snow right now, you're going to be very interested in these maps. And if you hate snow and you're not hungry for it, what about something normal, like food? Well, I've got good news for you too, in the form of today's sponsor. HelloFresh, fresh ingredients and tasty recipes delivered straight to your door. HelloFresh is a healthy meal subscription service that sends you everything you need for a restaurant quality meal right to your own kitchen. The grocery store? Pfft. Forget about it. Spend that quality time with your family this Valentine's Day season. No matter your lifestyle or your favorite foods, there's something for everybody with HelloFresh. I've mentioned this before, but I think it says a lot that my two-year-old gets excited about this stuff. Myself and my family have been fans of HelloFresh for ages. We've literally been using it for years, and it has become a very important part of our day-to-day lives. So what are you waiting for? Head on over to HelloFresh.com and use my code Y'all65 to get 65% off plus free shipping. Yeah, you heard that right. 65% off plus free shipping. And all you got to do is click that link in the description, use the code Y'all65, and you'll be on your way to eating good, son. Thank you so much to HelloFresh for sponsoring this video, and let's get back into it. It's really important to note that sudden stratospheric warming events don't automatically mean that you're going to walk outside, freeze your face off, and there's going to be like a million blizzards. That's not how it works. All this SSW stuff is happening 20 miles above our heads. It's going to take a while for what happens up there to affect us down here on the surface. So March temperatures may be a good way to see the effects of a February polar vortex event. But even as we go into March, there's no guarantee that we're going to see a ton of cold air because of this polar vortex falling apart. We just know that it could end up being like the 2018 Beast from the East. But hey, it could also end up just being a puff of cold air on a Saturday afternoon. According to the latest forecast models, a large plume of warm air in the stratosphere is going to take over the North Pole as early as February 18th. You can see very clearly how the sudden warming actually takes the cold air that was around the North Pole and pushes it outwards towards more mid mid-latitude areas like the United States. Because of this, some longer-range forecast models are hinting at a very favorable pattern along the East Coast for winter weather through the end of March.
Now, of course, it wouldn't be a traditional Ryan Hall y'all video if I didn't have to interrupt us here with a cell phone update because I learned some new information in the future as I was editing the video. And that's exactly what's happened here. You see, the stratospheric polar vortex is already starting to weaken significantly as I am filming this video. And probably tomorrow or just a couple of days after uploading this, we're gonna see the wind start to reverse. So that tells me that this is no longer an iffy forecast, okay? This is not like maybe we're gonna see a stratospheric, no. This is going to be a major sudden stratospheric warming event, and the impacts from that are going to be felt, but I don't know exactly how just yet. Will this be a repeat of 2018? Buddy, I don't know. Okay, but because of this major stratospheric warming, and just because of the intensity of it, and the fact that this will probably be the last one of the year or the season, I do think we've got a better shot than we've had in a very long time.
So here's what I think about all this. First up, let's take a look at the rest of February. As stated towards the beginning of this video, it's gonna take a while for the SSW event to affect our weather down here on the surface, so I'm really not expecting a big change right off the bat. That pesky southeastern ridge is gonna continue to keep us warm over here in the east, while the west and a lot of the northern US is gonna continue to be below average with their temperatures. Also, I think we're gonna continue to see slightly below average precipitation along the northwest coast and down here in the plains and the Gulf of Mexico regions, with above average precipitation in a ring from the northern Rockies through the Great Lakes and into the Appalachians. But because the polar vortex is literally falling apart thanks to the sudden stratospheric warming event, I think things are going to change significantly in March. Here's how I think temperatures are going to play out. Colder for pretty much everybody, especially in the northeastern US. Now, this ain't going to happen overnight. It's going to take a while. There's going to be some warm days, especially in early March, but the entire month of March is going to trend colder as we go forward. And as far as precipitation goes, I think we're going to be much above average in the west, especially as we get more of those big storms crashing into the country from the Pacific thanks to the increased activity in the jet stream. And I think we're going to be pretty normal or slightly above average as far as precipitation goes in the east. The fact of the matter is I think we're going to see a ton of big storms sweep through the country as we go into March. And if cold air is in place, winter weather is guaranteed for more people than have seen it so far this year. But even if we don't get a huge influx of cold Arctic air, the weather is still going to be active with heavy rain and severe thunderstorms in the warm sectors of these storms. Long story short, you should subscribe to this channel right now because you know we're going to be keeping an eye on this thing and we're going to keep you updated as we get new information. Additionally, when severe weather strikes or when the next snowstorm is upon us, we're going to be going live to cover it and you're going to want to have notifications on for that. And that's all for the weather today, guys. Huge shout out to my members. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure you slap that like button, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye. Ooh.